During my trip to Armenia, I used Yerevan as a base and traveled around the country by bus tours to the major places of interest. Today, we will start our trip from the Lake Sivan, which is one of the largest freshwater high-altitude lakes in Eurasia. It's situated at an altitude of 1900 meters above sea level. The total surface area of its basin is about 5,000 square kilometers, which makes up one-sixth of Armenia's territory. Lake Sivan is considered the jewel of Armenia with its Savanavank monastic complex, located on a narrow rocky peninsula, and it's one of the most prominent examples of medieval Armenian architecture. Initially, the monastery was built on a small island. After the artificial draining of Lake Sivan, the water level fell about 20 meters, and the island transformed into a peninsula. The monastery of Savanavank was founded in 874 by Princess Miriam, the daughter of Ashot I. At the time, Armenia was still struggling to free itself from Arab rule. Nowadays, there are two small churches left of a complex, the Holy Apostles and the Holy Mother of God. The lake surface area now is 940 square kilometers. The maximum depth is 95 meters. The maximum length is about 70 kilometers. Sivan is fed by 28 rivers, but only one flows out, Razdan River. The climate in the summer in the vicinities of Sivan Lake is comfortable. No matter how hot it is in the valley, high up there it is always cool. The temperature of water reaches 18-20 degrees. Winters are freezing, snowing, and often cloudy. We were lucky to get a beautiful sunny day with no wind at this time of the year. The next we're heading to Dilijan, one of the most important resorts in Armenia, situated within the Dilijan National Park. The town is often referred to as the Armenian Switzerland by the locals, as it's located in the valley at the height of 1500 meters above sea level and surrounded by the Lesser Caucasus Mountains from the north and Semyonovka Mountain Pass from the south. The forested town is home to numerous Armenian artists, composers, and filmmakers, and features some traditional Armenian architecture. According to popular legend, the name of the town is named after a shepherd called Dili, who was in love with his master's daughter. However, her father was against it and ordered to kill the shepherd. His sorrowful mother was mourning and looking for her only son all over the area and desperately crying, Dilijan, Dilijan. Jan is an Armenian endearment term added to the name of a friend or family member. Dilijan is also famous for its mineral water, with lots of mineral curing water fountains around the town. The Armenian paradise of Tavush region is rich in both natural and historical monuments. The monastery complex of Hagartsin, one of the wonders of Armenian medieval architecture, is located just 18 kilometers to the north of Dilijan. The monastery was gradually built from 10th to 13th centuries. Hagartsin complex includes three churches: the Church of the Holy Mother of God, St. Gregory, and St. Stephen's churches. Under the Church of the Holy Mother of God, there is an underground vault that has no way out. It is a church treasury where monks kept sacred relics from strangers. Hagertsen Monastery complex also has an underground passage that leads to the river. It was built as an escape route during earthquakes and wars. Hagertsen complex also includes a chapel, dining hall, bell tower, library, monk cells, and original Armenian hachkars. About 300 monks used to live in the monastery. If you enjoyed watching this video, I encourage you to subscribe, click like, and hit notification bell button to be updated of the new releases.